What is up, amigos? Today we're talking about a drag crisis. We'll be going through what it is and why it happens. So first of all, what is a drag crisis in aerodynamics? So let's say we have a ball here and the flow is going over it. And we know that the flow at some point will start to separate. And let's say it separates here and around here. And then we start getting quite a big wake here. With that comes a drag coefficient. We know that. Now, let's say the Reynolds number here was 10,000. Now, let's increase the Reynolds number to, let's say, 1 million. And what we will find is that the point at which the flow separates will be significantly different. So this one up here is laminar flow. And down here now, we have the flow coming around and it will start to separate much further back on this ball. And this is now turbulent flow. And that's because the turbulent flow has a lot more energy in the boundary layer. And if you don't know that, check out this video here. And so the flow can resist the adverse pressure gradient longer and stay attached. As a result, the wake will generally be smaller. And with that, the drag also drops, so the drag coefficient. When we go from this to this, usually there's quite a sudden change. So if I were to draw a graph of, let's say we have the Reynolds number on the x-axis and the drag coefficient on the y-axis, we'll often see something that happens, goes along like this and then drops very suddenly and then continues along. This point here is the drag crisis. And I don't know exactly why they call it a crisis. I mean, it's just a change. And even still, like, the word crisis is quite dramatic. You know, they could have used like kerfuffle or conundrum or something, but anyway, they say crisis here. And this is when the drag goes from a significantly higher value, or it just changes dramatically from one value to the other. And the reason why this happens is because, generally speaking, there's a change in the flow conditions. And most commonly, it's to do with how much energy the boundary layer has, as I mentioned here. As we go from one Reynolds number to the other, this is laminar and this is turbulent. So the boundary layer profile is going to be very different. And along with that comes the additional energy to stay attached, which means that the pressure drag will drop because we have a smaller wake here. As opposed to here, there's a much larger wake. So the pressure drag is quite high here, as opposed to the pressure drag is quite low here. And that's why we get this drop in drag, predominantly because of this drop in pressure drag. Now, because the flow is attached over the surface longer and it's also faster, it means that the skin friction drag will actually increase. But because this object here is a bluff body, the pressure drag is the main component of drag for this particular object, which means that this dominates the overall drag. So if it were the other case, for example, let's say the skin friction drag was the dominant component of drag, we wouldn't really get this happening here. In fact, we might actually get the opposite thing happening, where we actually get an increase in the drag because we have now transitioned to turbulence and the turbulent boundary layer has a higher skin friction drag. But because we have this wake here as a bluff body, we get this thing happening. So this is the drag crisis. And anytime you have this change in drag very suddenly, then that is a drag crisis. So that is what it is. Make sure to like and subscribe to this video, and I'll see you later. Peace out, amigos.